Deuteronomy, chapter 27, the altar on Mount Ebal. Moses and the elders of Israel commanded the people, saying, Keep all the commandment which I command you this day. It shall be on the day when you shall pass over the Jordan to the land which Yahweh your God gives you, that you shall set yourself up great stones and plaster them with plaster. And you shall write on them all the words of this law when you have passed over, that you may go in to the land which Yahweh your God gives you, a land flowing with milk and honey, as Yahweh, the God of your fathers, has promised you. It shall be, when you have passed over the Jordan, that you shall set up these stones, which I command you this day, in Mount Ebal, and you shall plaster them with plaster. There you shall build an altar to Yahweh your God, an altar of stones. You shall lift up no iron tool on them. You shall build the altar of Yahweh your God of uncut stones. And you shall offer burnt offerings thereon to Yahweh your God. And you shall sacrifice peace offerings, and shall eat there. And you shall rejoice before Yahweh your God. You shall write on the stones all the words of this law very plainly. Moses and the priests, the Levites, spoke to all Israel, saying, Keep silence and listen, Israel. This day you have become the people of Yahweh your God. You shall therefore obey the voice of Yahweh your God, and do his commandments and his statutes, which I command you this day. Curses pronounced from Ebal. Moses commanded the people the same day, saying, These shall stand on Mount Gerizim to bless the people when you have passed over the Jordan. Simeon and Levi, and Judah, and Issachar, and Joseph, and Benjamin. These shall stand on Mount Ebal for the curse. Reuben, Gad, and Asher, and Zebulun, Dan, and Naphtali. The Levites shall answer and tell all the men of Israel with a loud voice, Cursed is the man who makes an engraved or molten image, an abomination to Yahweh, the work of the hands of the craftsman, and sets it up in secret. All the people shall answer and say, Amen. Cursed is he who sets light by his father or his mother. All the people shall say, Amen. Cursed is he who removes his neighbor's landmark. All the people shall say, Amen. Cursed is he who makes the blind to wander out of the way. All the people shall say, Amen. Cursed is he who wrests the justice due to the foreigner, fatherless, and widow. All the people shall say, Amen. Cursed is he who lies with his father's wife, because he has uncovered his father's skirt. All the people shall say, Amen. Cursed is he who lies with any kind of animal. All the people shall say, Amen. Cursed is he who lies with his sister, the daughter of his father, or the daughter of his mother. All the people shall say, Amen. Cursed is he who lies with his mother-in-law. All the people shall say, Amen. Cursed is he who strikes his neighbor in secret. All the people shall say, Amen. Cursed is he who takes a bribe to kill an innocent person. All the people shall say, Amen. Cursed is he who doesn't confirm the words of this law to do them. All the people shall say, Amen. Chapter 28, The Blessings of Obedience. It shall happen, if you shall listen diligently to the voice of Yahweh your God, to observe to do all his commandments, which I command you this day, that Yahweh your God will set you on high above all the nations of the earth, and all these blessings shall come on you and overtake you, if you shall listen to the voice of Yahweh your God. You shall be blessed in the city, and you shall be blessed in the field. You shall be blessed in the fruit of your body, the fruit of your ground, the fruit of your animals, the increase of your livestock, and the young of your flock. Your basket and your kneading trough shall be blessed. You shall be blessed when you come in, and you shall be blessed when you go out. Yahweh will cause your enemies who rise up against you to be struck before you. They will come out against you one way, and will flee before you seven ways. Yahweh will command the blessing on you, in your barns, and in all that you put your hand to, and he will bless you in the land which Yahweh your God gives you. Yahweh will establish you for a holy people to himself, as he has sworn to you, if you shall keep the commandments of Yahweh your God and walk in his ways. All the peoples of the earth shall see that you are called by the name of Yahweh, and they shall be afraid of you. Yahweh will make you plenteous for good, in the fruit of your body, and in the fruit of your livestock, and in the fruit of your ground, in the land which Yahweh swore to your fathers to give you. Yahweh will open to you his good treasure in the sky, to give the rain of your land in its season, and to bless all the work of your hand. And you shall lend to many nations, and you shall not borrow. Yahweh will make you the head, and not the tail. And you shall be above only, and you shall not be beneath. If you shall listen to the commandments of Yahweh your God, which I command you this day, to observe and to do them, and shall not turn aside from any of the words which I command you this day, to the right hand or to the left, to go after other gods, to serve them. The curses of disobedience. But it shall come to pass, if you will not listen to the voice of Yahweh your God, to observe to do all his commandments and his statutes which I command you this day, that all these curses shall come on you and overtake you. You shall be cursed in the city, and you shall be cursed in the field. Your basket and your kneading trough shall be cursed. The fruit of your body, the fruit of your ground, the increase of your livestock, and the young of your flock shall be cursed. You shall be cursed when you come in, and you shall be cursed when you go out. Yahweh will send on you cursing, confusion, and rebuke in all that you put your hand to, until you are destroyed, and until you perish quickly, because of the evil of your doings, by which you have forsaken me. Yahweh will make the pestilence cling to you until he has consumed you from off the land where you go in to possess it. Yahweh will strike you with consumption and with fever and with inflammation and with fiery heat and with the sword and with blight and with mildew, and they shall pursue you until you perish. Your sky that is over your head shall be brass, and the earth that is under you shall be iron. Yahweh will make the rain of your land powder and dust. From the sky shall it come down on you, until you are destroyed. Yahweh will cause you to be struck before your enemies. You shall go out one way against them, and shall flee seven ways before them, and you shall be tossed back and forth among all the kingdoms of the earth. Your dead body shall be food to all birds of the sky and to the animals of the earth, and there shall be none to frighten them away. Yahweh will strike you with the boil of Egypt, and with the tumors, and with the scurvy, and with the itch, of which you cannot be healed. Yahweh will strike you with madness, and with blindness, and with astonishment of heart, and you shall grope at noonday, as the blind gropes in darkness, and you shall not prosper in your ways. And you shall be only oppressed and robbed always, and there shall be none to save you. You shall betroth a wife, and another man shall lie with her. You shall build a house, and you shall not dwell therein. You shall plant a vineyard, and shall not use its fruit. Your ox shall be slain before your eyes, and you shall not eat of it. Your donkey shall be violently taken away from before your face, and shall not be restored to you. Your sheep shall be given to your enemies, and you shall have none to save you. Your sons and your daughters shall be given to another people, and your eyes shall look and fail with longing for them all the day, and there shall be nothing in the power of your hand. The fruit of your ground and all your labors shall a nation which you don't know eat up, and you shall be only oppressed and crushed always, so that you shall be mad for the sight of your eyes which you shall see. Yahweh will strike you in the knees and in the legs with a sore boil, of which you cannot be healed, from the sole of your foot to the crown of your head. Yahweh will bring you and your king, whom you shall set over you, to a nation that you have not known, you nor your fathers, and there you shall serve other gods, wood and stone. You shall become an astonishment, a proverb and a byword among all the peoples where Yahweh shall lead you away. You shall carry much seed out into the field, and shall gather little in, for the locust shall consume it. You shall plant vineyards and dress them, but you shall neither drink of the wine nor gather the grapes, for the worm shall eat them. You shall have olive trees throughout all your borders, but you shall not anoint yourself with the oil, for your olive shall cast its fruit. You shall father sons and daughters, but they shall not be yours, for they shall go into captivity. All your trees and the fruit of your ground shall the locust possess. The foreigner who is in the midst of you shall mount up above you, higher and higher, and you shall come down, lower and lower. He shall lend to you, and you shall not lend to him. He shall be the head, and you shall be the tail. All these curses shall come on you, and shall pursue you, and overtake you, until you are destroyed. Because you didn't listen to the voice of Yahweh, your God, to keep his commandments and his statutes, which he commanded you. And they shall be on you for a sign and for a wonder, and on your seed forever. Because you didn't serve Yahweh, your God, with joyfulness and with gladness of heart, by reason of the abundance of all things. Therefore you shall serve your enemies, whom Yahweh shall send against you, in hunger and in thirst and in nakedness and in want of all things. And he shall put a yoke of iron on your neck until he has destroyed you. Yahweh will bring a nation against you from far, from the end of the earth, as the eagle flies, a nation whose language you shall not understand, a nation of fierce facial expressions, that shall not respect the person of the old, nor show favor to the young, and shall eat the fruit of your livestock and the fruit of your ground until you are destroyed. That also shall not leave you grain, new wine, or oil, the increase of your livestock, or the young of your flock until they have caused you to perish. They shall besiege you and all your gates until your high and fortified walls come down, in which you trusted, throughout all your land. And they shall besiege you in all your gates throughout all your land, which Yahweh your God has given you. You shall eat the fruit of your own body, the flesh of your sons and of your daughters, whom Yahweh your God has given you, in the siege and in the distress with which your enemies shall distress you. The man who is tender among you and very delicate, his eye shall be evil toward his brother, and toward the wife of his bosom, and toward the remnant of his children whom he has remaining, so that he will not give to any of them of the flesh of his children whom he shall eat, because he has nothing left him. In the siege and in the distress with which your enemy shall distress you in all your gates, the tender and delicate woman among you, who would not adventure to set the sole of her foot on the ground for delicateness and tenderness, her eye shall be evil toward the husband of her bosom, and toward her son, and toward her daughter, and toward her young one who comes out from between her feet, and toward her children whom she shall bear, for she shall eat them for want of all things secretly. In the siege and in the distress with which your enemy shall distress you in your gates. If you will not observe to do all the words of this law that are written in this book, that you may fear this glorious and fearful name, Yahweh your God, then Yahweh will make your plagues wonderful, and the plagues of your seed, even great plagues, and of long continuance, and severe sicknesses, and of long continuance. He will bring on you again all the diseases of Egypt, which you were afraid of, and they shall cling to you. Also every sickness and every plague which is not written in the book of this law, Yahweh will bring them on you until you are destroyed. You shall be left few in number, whereas you were as the stars of the sky for multitude, because you didn't listen to the voice of Yahweh your God. It shall happen that as Yahweh rejoiced over you to do you good and to multiply you, so Yahweh will rejoice over you to cause you to perish and to destroy you, and you shall be plucked from off the land where you go in to possess it. Yahweh will scatter you among all peoples, from the one end of the earth even to the other end of the earth, and there you shall serve other gods, which you have not known, you nor your fathers, even wood and stone. Among these nations you shall find no ease, and there shall be no rest for the sole of your foot. But Yahweh will give you there a trembling heart, and failing of eyes, and pining of soul. And your life shall hang in doubt before you, and you shall fear night and day, and shall have no assurance of your life. In the morning you shall say, I wish it were evening, and at evening you shall say, I wish it were morning. For the fear of your heart which you shall fear, and for the sight of your eyes which you shall see, Yahweh will bring you into Egypt again with ships, by the way of which I said to you, you shall see it no more again. And there you shall sell yourselves to your enemies for bond servants and for bond maids, and no man shall buy you. Chapter 29. The Covenant in Moab. These are the words of the covenant which Yahweh commanded Moses to make with the children of Israel in the land of Moab, besides the covenant which he made with them in Horeb. Moses called to all Israel and said to them, You have seen all that Yahweh did before your eyes in the land of Egypt to Pharaoh and to all his servants and to all his land, the great trials which your eyes saw, these signs, and those great wonders. But Yahweh has not given you a heart to know, and eyes to see, and ears to hear, to this day. I have led you 40 years in the wilderness. Your clothes have not grown old on you, and your shoes have not grown old on your feet. You have not eaten bread, neither have you drunk wine or strong drink, that you may know that I am Yahweh, your God. When you came to this place, Sihon, the king of Heshbon, and Og, the king of Bashan, came out against us to battle, and we struck them, and we took their land, and gave it for an inheritance to the Reubenites, and to the Gadites, and to the half-tribe of the Manassites. Keep therefore the words of this covenant, and do them, that you may prosper in all that you do. You stand this day, all of you, before Yahweh your God. Your heads, your tribes, your elders, and your officers, even all the men of Israel, your little ones, your wives, and your foreigner who is in the midst of your camps, from the one who cuts your wood to the one who draws your water, that you may enter into the covenant of Yahweh your God and into his oath, which Yahweh your God makes with you this day, that he may establish you this day to himself for a people, and that he may be to you a God, as he spoke to you, and as he swore to your fathers, to Abraham, to Isaac, and to Jacob. Neither with you only do I make this covenant and this oath, but with him who stands here with us this day before Yahweh our God, and also with him who is not here with us this day. For you know how we lived in the land of Egypt, and how we came through the midst of the nations through which you passed. And you have seen their abominations and their idols, wood and stone, silver and gold, which were among them. Lest there should be among you man or woman or family or tribe whose heart turns away this day from Yahweh our God, to go to serve the gods of those nations. Lest there should be among you a root that bears gall and wormwood. And it happen, when he hears the words of this curse, that he bless himself in his heart, saying, I shall have peace, though I walk in the stubbornness of my heart, to destroy the moist with the dry. Yahweh will not pardon him. But then the anger of Yahweh and his jealousy will smoke against that man, and all the curse that is written in this book shall lie on him. And Yahweh will blot out his name from under the sky. Yahweh will set him apart to evil out of all the tribes of Israel, according to all the curses of the covenant that is written in this book of the law. The generation to come, your children who shall rise up after you, and the foreigner who shall come from a far land, shall say, when they see the plagues of that land, and the sicknesses with which Yahweh has made it sick, and that the whole land of it is sulfur and salt and a burning, that it is not sown, nor bears, nor any grass grows therein, like the overthrow of Sodom and Gomorrah, Admah and Zeboiim, which Yahweh overthrew in his anger and in his wrath. Even all the nations shall say, why has Yahweh done thus to this land? What does the heat of this great anger mean? Then men shall say, because they forsook the covenant of Yahweh, the God of their fathers, which he made with them when he brought them forth out of the land of Egypt, and went and served other gods, and worshipped them, gods that they didn't know, and that he had not given to them. Therefore the anger of Yahweh was kindled against this land, to bring on it all the curse that is written in this book. And Yahweh rooted them out of their land in anger, and in wrath, and in great indignation, and cast them into another land, as at this day. The secret things belong to Yahweh our God, but the things that are revealed belong to us and to our children forever, that we may do all the words of this law. Chapter 30, Restoration Promised. It shall happen, when all these things have come on you, the blessing and the curse which I have set before you, and you shall call them to mind among all the nations where Yahweh your God has driven you, and shall return to Yahweh your God, and shall obey his voice according to all that I command you this day, you and your children, with all your heart and with all your soul, that then Yahweh your God will turn your captivity and have compassion on you, and will return and gather you from all the peoples where Yahweh your God has scattered you. If any of your outcasts are in the uttermost parts of the heavens, from there will Yahweh your God gather you, and from there he will bring you back. And Yahweh your God will bring you into the land which your fathers possessed, and you shall possess it, and he will do you good and multiply you above your fathers. Yahweh your God will circumcise your heart and the heart of your seed to love Yahweh your God with all your heart and with all your soul, that you may live. Yahweh your God will put all these curses on your enemies and on those who hate you, who persecuted you. You shall return and obey the voice of Yahweh, and do all his commandments, which I command you this day. Yahweh your God will make you plenteous in all the work of your hand, in the fruit of your body, and in the fruit of your livestock, and in the fruit of your ground, for good. For Yahweh will again rejoice over you for good, as he rejoiced over your fathers. If you shall obey the voice of Yahweh your God to keep his commandments and his statutes, which are written in this book of the law, if you turn to Yahweh your God with all your heart and with all your soul, the choice of life or death. For this commandment which I command you this day, it is not too hard for you, neither is it far off. It is not in heaven that you should say, who shall go up for us to heaven and bring it to us and make us to hear it, that we may do it? Neither is it beyond the sea that you should say, who should go over the sea for us and bring it to us and make us to hear it, that we may do it? But the word is very near to you, in your mouth and in your heart, that you may do it. Behold, I have set before you this day life and good, and death and evil, in that I command you this day to love Yahweh your God, to walk in his ways, and to keep his commandments and his statutes and his ordinances, that you may live and multiply, and that Yahweh your God may bless you in the land where you go in to possess it. But if your heart turns away, and you will not hear, but shall be drawn away and worship other gods and serve them, I denounce to you this day that you shall surely perish. You shall not prolong your days in the land where you pass over the Jordan to go in to possess it. I call heaven and earth to witness against you this day that I have set before you life and death, the blessing and the curse. Therefore, choose life, that you may live, you and your seed, to love Yahweh your God, to obey his voice, and to cling to him, for he is your life and the length of your days, that you may dwell in the land which Yahweh swore to your fathers, to Abraham, to Isaac, and to Jacob, to give them.